हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम
वेलकम टू पीएससी फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर पेपर टू न्यूमेरिकल एनालिसिस। सो वी हैव डन वेरी सफिशिएंट प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन इटरेशन मेथड्स। सो दिस इज लास्ट लेक्चर, दैट इज लेक्चर 6 ऑन न्यूमेरिकल मेथड्स, सॉरी दैट इज इटरेशन मेथड। सो नाउ टिल नाउ वी हैव व्हाट वी हैव सीन इज हाउ टू डू द इटरेशन मेथड। सपोज एफ ऑफ एक्स इक्वल टू 0, देन वी राइट इट एक्स इक्वल टू फाइव ऑफ एक्स एंड फिक्स एन एक्स नॉट, that is initial value, then we go on iterating and we say that approximate root, we get the approximate root of the equation f of x equal to 0. So this method will be explain iteration method will be asked for 2 marks. Okay, explain iteration method, this will be asked for 2 marks in the semester examination. And we know what is condition for convergence of the iteration method: mod phi dash of x is must be less than 1, and we know what is the algorithm. Okay, so till now in the up to last video lectures we have seen these 9 problems. So now let us move to the 10th problem, that is find a real root of the equation, find a real root of the equation corrected to 3 decimal places. So what is the equation given? 2x minus 3 equal to cos x. Okay, 2x minus 3x is equal to cos x. So this is a given equation. So for that, what we need to do? So already they have given where the root lies also. So the root lies in the interval 1.5 comma 5 by 2. So directly we shall start with the solution. So already we have f of x is given. That is 2x minus 3 minus cos x is equal to 0. Okay, once this equation is given, and they have said that root lies between 1.5 and 5 by 2, so no need to go for an intermediate value theorem. So directly we can write this as, so it can be written as, so it can be written as 2x is equal to cos x plus 3. So this implies x is equal to 1 by 2 into cos x plus 3. So this is our phi of x. So this we are going to treat it as phi of x. So therefore phi of x is equal to what? 1 by 2 into cos x plus 3. So already they have given root lies between 1.5 and 5 by 2. So just we need to check mod phi dash of x. So mod phi dash of x, so this is going to be 1 by 2 mod 1 by 2. So cos x differentiation is minus sin x. Okay, yeah, so this is going to be sin x by 2, and we know that mod sin x is always less than or equal to 1. So this is always less than 1. So therefore mod phi dash of x is always less than 1 for all x in the interval 1.5 comma 5 by 2. Okay, yeah. So next, immediately when we have this condition of convergence is satisfied, we go for the iteration. So let x naught is equal to 1.5. we don't know what is the value of the actual root, so let us start with 1.5. so we obtain x1 is equal to phi of x naught, so that is equal to, so 1 by 2 into cos of cos x naught plus 3. In place of x we have x naught. So what is x naught? 1.5. so that is 1 by 2 into cos 1.5 plus 3. So use your calculator in the radian mode. So this gives you 1.5354. so after getting x1, so this will be the answer. So when you go for the x2, so that is phi of x1 in place of x0, that is in place of 0.5, press answer key, then hit equal to, then you are going to get x2. So x2 is 1.5177. again press equal to, okay, then we are going to get x3, that is phi of x2, so that is equal to 1.5 265. Okay. So now x4 is 5 of x3. So we see that the root has not been converted, therefore we are going for the next iteration. So that is 1.5221. So x5, that is 5 of x4, so which is equal to 1.5243. So the root has converged up to 2 decimal places, we want 3 decimal places. So let us go for x6, so that is 5 of x5, which is equal to 1.5232. So 1.52. So one more iteration, let us see, that is x7, that is 5 of x6. So this gives out to be 1.5238. Yeah. So now see that. The root has been converged. The question is asked up to 3 decimal places, right? So up to 3 decimal places. So we have got an approximate root up to 3 decimal places, that is 1.523. Therefore, the value of the approximate root, root is 1.523. Okay. So this is a very simple question because half of the work is already done here. That is where the root lies is given. So we just have to go with the phi of x and check mod phi dash of x less than 1 and begin with the iteration. Begin the iteration with the x not equal to 1.5 and we see that for 7 steps it has been converged. The approximate root of the the value of the approximate root is 1.523. Okay. Yeah, we shall see a similar question. Find the positive root of the equation x into e power x equal to 1, given that the root lies between 0 and 1. So here also where the root lies is given, okay, between 0 and 1. So therefore directly we can go for the phi of x. So the given equation is, can be written as, the equation can be written as, so equation can be written as x equal to 1 by e power x, that is e power minus x. Okay, so that is, therefore we have phi of x is equal to e power minus x. So what about phi dash of x? Phi dash of x is minus e power minus x. So mod phi dash of x is equal to, so mod phi dash of x is equal to mod e power minus x. So that is mod 1 by e power x. So numerator is 1 and denominator is something 2.7 into the power x. So therefore this is going to be less than 1 for all x. Okay. Therefore mod phi dash of x is less than 1. Okay, for all x in the interval 0, 1. Yes. So now see that choose x naught wisely. See, when we choose x naught, so we must remember that f of x naught, if it is very close to 0, then x naught, the root converges faster, because already we know f of x naught is the root. If you assume that f of x naught is the root, then it must be very close to 0. So therefore choice of x naught, you have to choose x naught in such a way that f of x naught is very close to 0. Okay, this is how you need to choose x naught. So I am going to choose x naught as 0.5, because f of 0.5, that is 0.5 into e power 0.5 is approximately 0. Then we see that x1 is phi of x naught, so that is e power minus 0.5. So that this gives you how much? 0.60653. okay. Yeah, so next let us see the x2. X2 is phi of x1, that is e power minus x1. Okay, so this gives you how much? 0.54524. So x3, that is phi of x2, so this gives you 0.5797. So you can see that root has not been converted. So x4, 0.56007. So x5, 0.57117. X6, 0.56486. See, there is a jump in the values, so we have to go on iterating. X7 is 0.56844, and see X8. So x8 is 0.56641. So root has been converged up to 2 decimal points. So if you want 3 decimal points, so then go for x9, 0.56756. So 67 it is, and here it is 66. So let us see one more iteration. So point x10 is 0.56566. On second, the x10 is 0.56691. Okay, so now see this. So I think we can stop the iteration process here, because we see here this 0.5669. So this is greater than 5, so therefore you can increase this one. So this can be written as 0.567. Okay, and here also we have 0.567, so therefore the root is the approximate value of the root. Therefore, the approximate value of the root is 0.567. Okay, corrected to 3 decimal places. Corrected to 3 decimal places. Yeah. So this is also one of the very easy problem, that is find the positive root of the equation x into e power x equal to 1. So this is can be written as phi of x equal to e power minus x, and you have seen that mod phi dash of x is less than 1 for all x in the interval 0, 1. Yes. Now, so choose x naught. So how to choose x naught? You have to choose x naught in such a way that f of x naught must be very close to 0. So choose x naught such that f of x naught must be very close to 0. Okay, and x naught must belongs to where? The given interval, the given interval, that is a comma b. So if you follow this, then we get the convergence very faster. Okay, then the convergence is very fast, then the convergence of root, that is getting the approximate root, is very fast. Okay, you have to choose x naught such that f of x naught is very close to 0. Fine. Yeah, so now go on iteration, we get a approximate root as 0.567. okay. We shall see the last problem on this iteration method, that is 12th problem. So use iteration method to find a real root of the equation sin x equal to 10 into x minus 1, given that root lies between 1 and pi. So here also where the root lies is already given, where the root lies is already given, and the function is also given, we just go for a solution. So solution already we have f of x is equal to, so sin x minus 10x, okay, plus 10 equal to 0. So already they are given, the root lies between 1 and pi. So we just go for the finding phi of x, that is sin x is equal to 10x is equal to sin x plus 10. So x is equal to sin x plus 10 divided by 10. Okay, so this we can write it as 1 plus sin x divided by 10. Okay, so this is our phi of x now. So therefore phi of x is equal to what? 1 plus sin x divided by 10. Yeah. So now let us see phi dash of x. So what is phi dash of x? So phi dash of x is equal to, so differentiation of 1 is 0 and sin x is cos x divided by 10. So when you take mod phi dash of x, so this is equal to mod cos x divided by 10. So we know that since mod cos x is always less than or equal to 1. Okay, so this is mod phi dash of x is always less than mod 1 by 10, and 1 by 10 we know it is 0.1, therefore it is less than 1. So therefore mod phi dash of x is always less than 1 for all x that belongs to the interval 1 comma pi. Okay, so now let us choose x naught such that f of x naught is very close to 0. I am going to choose x naught as 1, x naught as 1. So then phi of x naught, so that is equal to the first iteration, which gives you 1 plus sin x naught divided by 10. So that is 1 plus sin 1 divided by 10. Use your scientific calculator in the radian mode, then we get a sin 1 value as sin 1 value. Okay, so then we get the value first iteration 1.0841. So now let us go for x2 is nothing but phi of x1. So 1 plus sin x1 divided by 10, so this gives you 1.0884. so for transcendental equation, use your scientific calculator in the radian mode. So for x3 we get phi of x2, so that is 1 plus sin x2 divided by 10, so this gives you 1.0886. so similarly x4, so already see that the root has been converged up to 3 decimal points. So if you want one more, calculate x4. So x4 is phi of x3, x4 is phi of x3. So then see that so this gives you 1 plus sin x3 divided by 10, so this is going to be 1.0886 again. So now we can observe that x3 and x4 have almost same values, therefore the approximate root, the value of approximate root, mate root is 1.0886. okay, so this is also one more very simple problem. So function is given and where the root lies is given. So what we need to do, we have to go for phi of x is 1 plus sin x divided by 10, check mod phi dash of x, and it is less than 1 for all x in the interval 1 comma pi. So choose x naught. So I repeat again, choose x naught such that f of x naught is very close to 0, then we get a very few iterations. Okay, so if you are choosing x naught away from 0, then we get more iterations. If you are choosing x naught such that f of x naught is very close to 0, then we get few iterations. So choice of x naught does not change the value of the root. Okay, it only changes the number of steps. So choice of x naught does not change the value of the root. Okay, yeah, so given that the x naught must be in the given interval, so that also there. So x naught such that x naught belongs to the given interval a comma b. Okay, So very simple method, iteration method, that is very simple. So already we have seen the question which was asked been in the year 2019. Okay, so that is find the cube root of the equation. So this was asked in the year 2019 for 5 marks. Okay, and the method has been asked for 2 marks. The method has been asked for the 2 marks. Okay, and these are the sufficient example. We have given 12 examples, so you can try any other. Okay, with the help of these 12 examples, please do this small homework assignment. Okay, so this is the assignment which you need to do. Find the root of the following equations using iteration method. So this is an assignment question, assignments. Okay, so this is assignment. So please do the assignment questions and submit it in the Google Classroom. So we shall meet in the next lecture with the Newton-Raphson method. Thank you.